Hi, I'm your host, Nijel Vince, and welcome to the essence of the martial art. Have you ever wondered about the true origins of the martial arts? Did it really begin in Asia or Africa, as some believe? And what is the difference? We hope to answer these and other questions concerning the yet popular but ever-changing world of the martial arts. We are inside a martial arts school, also called a dojo. Today, we're going to compare the martial arts and the martial artists themselves. We intend to see what makes the martial arts and the artists different, and how, if at all, the history of the martial arts contributes to these differences. We will also look into the future of the martial arts. Keep an open mind as we explore these and other topics, and you will be enlightened. With that in mind, sit back, relax, as we enter into the essence of the martial arts. Choose your weapon.
Yeah. It's the strong.
Our style comes from the island of Okinawa, and the original islanders had a style called Tode. When some emissaries from China brought with them some practitioners of Chuan Fa, the two styles were merged together. Chuan Fa comes from the Henan province at the Shaolin Temple in China.
Okinawan Shorinru consists of three main divisions: kata, waza, and kumite. Kata is the forms, which is the practice of the art, and waza is the techniques used in self-defense typically and in free sparring. Kumite is free sparring, where we learn to judge distance and learn physical conditioning and to work with a partner.
Part of our training includes conditioning. We'll use heavy bags and makiwaras to increase our strength and our endurance, also to perfect our form.
Some of the physical benefits to Okinawan Shorinru is it keeps you supple, it keeps you fit in your stamina, conditioned in your muscles, and it's also a great stress reliever.
Okinawan weapons developed because there was a ban on owning weapons during the late 14th century up through almost World War II.
Yeah.
During that time, the Okinawan villagers, the fishermen and the farmers, used their own farm and fishing implements as weapons. That's how we end up with a bow and with a sai. We end up with the nunchaka and the various other weapons, such as the kama. All are used as farm implements and as fishing implements.
After a long, stressful day on the Los Angeles freeways, there's nothing better than taking out a magawara and as punching it as hard as you can for 20 minutes. It is absolutely wonderful for relieving stress.
My name is Eric Perlman, and the discipline I study is Shaolin Kempo. I've been training now for roughly about 19 years. Kempo means law of the fist. Kempo is actually a Japanese term that describes our martial art, which is actually a Chinese-based martial art. Kempo was born in Hawaii in about the 1940s. A gentleman by the name of James Matosi had relocated to Hawaii in the 1940s, and he brought with him a certain style of martial arts. He then had a student named William Chow, and William Chow is a pretty famous martial artist for bringing in the Chinese circular side to the harder style that Matosi had brought to Hawaii with him. So between the Chinese style and the harder, you know, Japanese styles that Mitoshi was studying, he created Shaolin Kempo. So William Chow's father was a monk named Hun Chow, and that's where the Shaolin Chinese side comes from in the system. Martial arts to me is a way to enhance your life physically, mentally, spiritually, for many people. It's something that's kept me very disciplined and guided me in a positive direction throughout all my adolescence and up to today. Martial arts has helped me in everyday life because I do use it every day. So a lot of times we think of martial arts being used physically in confrontation, but true martial artists use their training to overcome obstacles and become better people. So things that people have to deal with on a day-to-day basis, from punctuality to accountability to consistency to discipline in the daily routine, that's what the martial arts has provided for me. Traditionally in Kempo, it's an empty-handed art. However, in the Shaolin side of what we do as we advance later on in the ranks, we do see a lot of the Shaolin weapons come into play. In our system, we train with a lot of your typical calisthenics, stretching routines, and a lot of times we'll go into isometric exercises. We'll use dynamic tension for muscle strengthening. The standard things that are going to help increase the quality of our actual martial arts techniques.
Hi, I'm Tess Blangino. I'm standing in front of Fairtex in San Francisco. Let's check inside and see what makes this martial arts training school unique from all the rest.
To me, I don't compete. I use it to get in shape and to really more of discovering myself. I think that's more important to me, is about building my self-confidence. Because I fight in a different way. I mean, in a business sense, we all do, you know, we all fight. And so I fight in business and not necessarily in the ring, because I don't like to necessarily hit people or get hit.
Mr. Wong created Fairtex Muay Thai Camp in Thailand as a hobby to fulfill his love and passion for Muay Thai. It was a way for Mr. Wong to give back to the community by giving poor children, young men, a second chance at life through Muay Thai, thus far keeping them off the streets and away from drugs. Since 1975, Fairtex has been dedicated to the training, management, and promotions of professional Muay Thai fighters, boxers, mixed martial arts, and athletes. This tradition is growing as Fairtex has expanded with 2 champs in Thailand, 2 gyms in US, and 6 gyms in Japan. Fairtex students from all over the world, Holland, Russian, China, Brazil, USA, to Australia, are champions consistently ranked as the world's best.
China and many places in Asia needs to be credited, not as being the birthplace of the martial arts, but one of many places where the martial arts developed. But now let's talk about where the martial arts began. You know, before I came along, there were a few people who are very reputable in the martial arts, and they actually talked about where the martial arts began long before I did. I came along in 1990 and wrote a pivotal book called Nuba Wrestling, the Original Art. But let's go back before 1990. There are 2 well-known masters of the martial arts that everyone is familiar with in all areas of the discipline. Masutatsu Oyama, the famed God Hand in Japanese karate. He developed a reputation for being able to kill bulls with his bare hand and chop the horns off in the process. But he wrote a book early in his career The title of the book is This is Karate, and he went on to do a follow-up. And in those books, he tells you quite clearly that the martial arts began.
Don't go out there and sit and wait to get one good shot off. Throw leather in his face. All you have to do is fight. Go out there and fight.
Still easy hook crash. Good.
Let's go beat the shit.
Let's go, man. Let's go, man. Come on.
Training background. Started jiu-jitsu training about 9 years ago. Started training with Hoist Gracie, famous Hoist Gracie. That everybody knows. Shortly after that, I met Roy Harris, who's my jiu-jitsu instructor, and been with him for about